Right, I'm going to run you through how to tie your own hook lengths, because if you're like me, you might like tying your own hook lengths. If you don't like tying your own hook lengths, you can get any of the pre-tied hooks, of course. But I think I'm probably just a little bit sad, but I actually like tying hooks. I know some people don't, but it's quite methodical. I feel quite prepared, and I like to tie my own hooks, you know, when I can, when I've got the time. So might turn the football on or something like that and tie a few. So I'm going to show you how I basically go about it. I'm currently tying some 14K KMBs with a bayonet on the end to 020 in the AccuPower. They're going in my 4-inch hook length box. So I've just tied a bayonet on the end there in a bit of a loop. I'll see if I can put that so you can see that there. Maybe against my black will be a bit better. Look at that. All right, so you can see that I've tied the bayonet there in a loop, so it's going to be free. And I'm just going to cut a length of line off, probably about a foot long, something like that. I like to have a little bit more line than I need because it does make things easier. I'm going to take my 14 KKM, just going to go in through the back of the eye like so, and I'm going to pull this up. Now I've tied this loop, so hopefully the bayonet sits at the bottom. Again, I'll just see if you can see that. That's sort of how long it is against the hook. I don't know if you can see that there, if I try and hold that just like that. So you can see there, that's how it is. And I'm just going to twizzle round probably about 22, 23 times. I've always been a fan of, I don't like using like little bits of rubber and that, so because I think it's a bit faffy. So I like to twizzle my line all the way down. And again, it's each to their own, but this is just how I like to do it. So I like to, about 22, 23 wraps, just as you're starting to go around the bend of the hook, and then the line back through the very back of the eye. So I'm pulling back out like that. Now I always give it a good tug to make sure it's on properly, like that. And you can see there, I've got a lovely bayonet. I'll put it back on my black sleeve. There we go. Let's see if I can just sort this out for you. You can see there, look, the bayonet just sits at the bottom. It's in a loop, so it's nice and flexible, and my hook's ready to go. Now, this is the bit that I know a lot of people struggle with. It's getting them the right length in your hook length box. So all you do is you hook it round the peg that you want it to the length and go round the peg at the other end. So you can see that I've just basically gone round the pegs like that, hooked on one end, round at the other end, nip the line together and take the hook off. So now that loop that I've got in my hand there is a set length. That is the perfect length for this pegs that I'm going to put it on. And I just take that doubled up piece of line. I like to fold it over and then put my loop tire in. 1, 2, 3. Pop that on there like that. Wet that up and I've tied myself a loop. Now that should be, give everything a little bit of a tug. Trimmer off, always just leave a couple of mil tag on there, line safely to one side. And you'll see now when I pop this in the box, round the loop at one end, and I can just pull that over the peg at the other. So with thick line, you tend to find it shortens it a little bit. I'm talking like 3 or 4 mil. That's absolutely fine because the line's got a little bit of give in it and you can just basically pull it over and I just pop it down. And I'm ready to tie the next one. And don't tend to tie loads in one go. I tend to tie like 8, 9 of each one. If there's one in particular that I know I'm going to use a lot of. So, for example, I've got a 16 KKM to 016 there, which I know I'm going to use a lot of. I probably tie 15 or so of those. But in the rest, I just like the flexibility of having different options available. So I'm just going to go around tying 6 or 7 of each one. And hopefully that has showed you how to tie the perfect hook length for your hook length box.